You know, I don't know. I've heard about these NFTs for so long now, but I just have no idea how I can implement them in my own business. Well, if that's you and you're somebody who's saying this, this is the video for you, as I'm gonna go into exactly how you can start implementing NFTs today. So let's get into it. Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of By the Wallington Twins. So today I'm going to be taking a look into how NFTs can be implemented into really any type of business in any different industry. But first, I'm going to go into why NFTs are important. One of the most important things and reasons why NFTs are so important is because it creates this transparent ledger that is easily trackable on the blockchain. And what it does is it provides verifiable provenance over really anything that you own. Another reason why NFTs are super important is because whether or not we like it, 20 years ago, a lot of the things that we care about today is very, very different. I mean, every day people are looking on Instagram, how many more followers do I have? How many likes do I have? Or on Twitter, do I have that blue check mark? These are all things that so many people care about. And whether we like it or not, as we progress forward, the space and the world is just gonna get more digital. So this technology is something that we have to learn to embrace. I mean, you see kids playing Fortnite, they care about the skins that they're wearing in the game. There's these 2K Madden cards, all of these things people care about. And why do they care about it? It's because these fashion statements are things that express who you are. They express what you love in this world, who your identity is. So all of these digital assets are another representation of who we are, and this is why it's gonna be so important as we move into the future. I know that talking about these things, about how we all care about how we look, might sound a little vain, but at the end of the day, it's how everybody is in the real world. I mean, people in the real world buy expensive jewelry, they take photos when they're on vacation. So whether or not we like it, this world is becoming more digital. It's becoming this way for a very long time, and it's not going anywhere. So embracing NFTs now is just the way it's gonna go. So I know that when I kind of say that, you know, a lot of the clothes that we wear or these photos that we take for Instagram or all of these things that we use to showcase who we are might sound a little vain, and maybe it is, but at the end of the day, we're humans, and what we do is we like to interact with others and we like to show off. And you can be cynical about this, or you can just look at it as it is and say, it's us being human beings. So in my perspective, I like to just listen to what I see, and we're human beings. And as we continue to move forward, these are all things that we're gonna continue to wanna highlight. And this includes in the digital world. So as we continue to look into NFTs, NFTs have been here for 5 or 6 years now, but in the mainstream media, a lot of the times when you look at NFTs, you only see art or collectibles. And don't get me wrong, this is very true, but where NFTs are gonna be super applicable are things outside of this, because I think this art phase is already starting to phase out a little bit, and it's where these real world applications is where NFTs can start really taking effect. When I say that there's other things that NFTs can be used for, the biggest thing that I believe will be leveraged by some of these bigger businesses is the actual smart contract that's beneath the NFTs. As an extension of why this smart contract is so important is because this smart contract can really do anything. It could serve as a purpose to a VIP concert, VIP green room backstage. It can show as something that you went to, like a concert, anything like that. This smart contract can have anything built into it. And when I say smart contract, what I'm referring to is the back end of the NFT. And really, you can put anything on this. It could be a title deed. It could be a ticket to a conference. It can be VIP access to a green room. It can be all of these different things. So I think as we move forward into the next decade, smart contracts, which is on the back end of the NFTs, is gonna be something that we see more regularly used in our everyday lives, and it may not be so much NFT based. So what I foresee happening is that this smart contract side is what we're gonna encounter in our everyday lives as we move into the next decade, but the NFT front is what is gonna be used so that the smart contract can sit behind it. I mean, when you think about it realistically, there's only very few people that actually are into these collectibles and NFTs and stuff like that. But of the 8 billion of us on Earth, there's a ton of us that are already contractually obligated on a ledger. It's just on physical documents. So using the smart contract of things moving into the future, whether it's going to a restaurant, when you buy a book, whether you're going to a sporting event, buying a home, all these things are gonna be based on an NFT infrastructure, because we already encounter it on a day-to-day basis. And for a business to start implementing NFTs, there's no downside to them. So when you think about it, there's very, very few collectors out there that actually like to collect things. things. So of the 8 billion people on Earth, it only makes sense because we're already contractually obligated to so many different things on a ledger. But using the NFT infrastructure and the smart contract, all these big businesses are gonna start leveraging this because it just makes it so much easier to keep track of things. So it's inevitable. The other extension I'll make on this point is that there's gonna be a ton of losers in this industry that create NFTs with the smart contract and they're gonna promise the world and they're gonna fail. But it's just like back in the day when Apple came out with the App Store. There were so many junk apps, but for the ones that survived, they absolutely crushed it and smashed the game. So right now, for these companies that are starting to really learn what to do and what not to do, these are the ones that are gonna be around the longest. All right, so at this point, I think it's appropriate to give an actual example of how an NFT can be implemented really anywhere. And so let's use an art exhibit for an example where they use an NFT instead of like a physical admission or even like a digital admission to get into the art exhibit. So how would this actually happen? So what would happen is this art exhibit, instead of creating these like e-tickets or even physical tickets to get theirs, they would hire an artist to create an NFT for the event. And what would happen is once this NFT was created, of course, they'd market it on their website. People would purchase this NFT, and then when they show up on their phone, they would have the NFT, which would grant access to this actual event. And the reason why there's only a plus side for the business here is because, well, there's two things. So number one, right when they create an NFT, it's now an asset, which again, if it's a good company, this asset is gonna appreciate over time as long as they've done a good job. And of course, I'll say it, there's gonna be companies that don't do a good job, but I'm assuming in a perfect world right now, because again, still, even if it doesn't do that well, the second reason why it's so perfect for a business to create an NFT is any resale of this NFT, there's gonna be royalties that go back to the business. So not only is it gonna be created into digital asset right away, but these businesses are gonna be making money on these royalty sales if it gets sold again. And I'll give you another example. So let's say you own a pizza shop. And so let's give another example where an NFT may be applicable to your business. So me, I'm very familiar with the gym and fitness industry. Let's say you're a gym owner. Let's say you're opening a gym and you have max capacity of 100 people, just giving a very easy number here, 100 people, and you say, you know what, I want to create an NFT instead of just selling a membership and then stopping at 100. What I want to do is I want to create an NFT, I want to sell 100 of them, and I want people to know that this is exclusive. When you buy this NFT, you have access to training, nutrition, our 24-hour gym, all these perks of owning this NFT. And let's say out of nowhere somebody says, okay, well, I don't want to be a member here anymore. They will have a website where they can just resell this NFT, and there can be a wait list of people that are waiting for these NFTs to become available. So there is really no need for memberships anymore if you have this NFT. This NFT on the blockchain is easily accessible by everybody to see. It's totally transparent, and really it's going to decrease a ton of paperwork for everybody. And I can come up with a ton of ideas for this stuff because I love it, and my brother and I will be opening up our own brokerage, but I will digress on that idea for now, and that'll be a whole different video. The last example I'll give of why NFTs are so important, especially for artists and musicians, is, well, let's think back to the days of Picasso. So imagine Picasso made his painting, but with his painting, he created a small digital NFT that represented ownership for this painting. Well, what he could have done is he could have built into the smart contract behind the NFT a 5 or even 10% royalty, so that every time his painting or paintings got sold, his family, when he passed away or when he was alive, would always get 5 or 10% of the resale value. So right now, his family would be absolutely set, but instead of getting these royalties, nobody from his family gets money anymore from the resale value of these paintings. And for artists, especially the ones that pass away, their art just increases in value. And you know, the same thing for music, for artists. When somebody makes a song, instead of creating this physical album or even like a digital album, anything like that, they'll create an NFT for it. And the same principles apply that I've already said. So the royalties that come from resale of these things is what's creating so much buzz for these artists and musicians. And this is just for one field, but again, that smart contract behind the NFT is why I believe it's gonna be so crucial in the next decade. All right, so to wrap up this video, I do again wanna say there's always risks involved in the NFT space. That's why it's super important to do your research. I mean, use me as a resource. You can always DM me, you can check me on Instagram. Wallington Twins Real Estate. Really, there's a lot of ways you can contact me, but you can do your own research. Like, there's information everywhere, and we're at that stage now where buyers are getting a lot more smart. So in closing, I do want to say that there are of course inherent risks involved with NFTs, but there's a time right now where there's so many industries that don't involve NFTs. Maybe you're in the HVAC industry, maybe you're in the fitness industry, maybe you're in the real estate industry like me. There's so many different industries where there's so much potential for NFTs and smart contracts that if you put in the work right now and just do a little bit of research and you put your own twist on things, there's a lot of amazing things you can do with these smart contracts. And I know one project right now that's creating a bit of buzz is a project called Tyke, and it's a project I have my eye on because obviously I'm in the real estate space. And so Ryan, he's another YouTube creator, the creator of Tyke. They haven't dropped their NFT collection yet, but I know that Ryan does flip houses for a living, and I believe this property that he purchased, he was gonna flip it, but he decided to rent it out or become an Airbnb or something like that. But I know what he's planning is holders of his NFT collection are gonna have immediate access to actually be able to rent out this property, and it's beautiful. You can check out his channel, I'll drop in the links below, but I mean, this is a project that has real world application, and it's not just some gimmicky art collection. It's gonna be somewhere you can rent out a space on vacation, and this is fantastic. So always do your own research with these projects. I know there's a lot going on. I'm learning something new every day, and I mean, it's not always the easiest space to navigate. So feel free, reach out to me if you have any questions. If there's a video idea you want me to talk about, I'm completely open to it as well, but I want to say thank you for listening. You can find my Instagram information below. It's at Wallington Twins Real Estate, or you can email us at wallingtontwins@gmail.com. So I thank you very much for watching, and take care.